The type of synchronization we use for atomic sections is called mutual exclusion or lock. So this is really an example of where a lock will be needed. What we really need to do is say something like, I'm entering, don't come in here. Then do this, then say, I'm leaving, now you can come in. And when this one is done, this one can then say, I'm entering, I'm leaving. But if this thread comes and wants to continue past this point, while the first thread is already in the critical section, we should wait here. So what we want here really is, before we get into the critical section, we need to lock a lock, let's call that count lock, that corresponds to a given element of this array. So count lock of L is a lock that corresponds to count of L. If this lock currently is open, then we will enter. If this lock is currently locked, then we will spin there until it becomes open. Once we have grabbed the lock, we can enter here. The other thread will do the same. So the first one of them that succeeds in grabbing the lock will enter this critical section. The other one will now realize that this count lock has been locked and will have to wait there. Once we leave the critical section, we will unlock the lock, and now if this one is waiting here, at that point it sees that the lock is now available and starts executing the critical section and then releases the lock. Note that having the lock and unlock enforces mutual exclusion of this code. We do this alone and we do this alone, but it doesn't impose a particular order between them. So whichever of them comes first to this lock will execute its critical section first. So we can either have this happen first and then this happen second, or we can have this happens first and this happens second. What the lock is really preventing is interleaving where these are happening simultaneously. But it doesn't prevent, for example, this second thread doing this first, and only then the first thread gets to do it.